Hey, today I'm making a Fallout-inspired house number on my CNC. Let's go. First, I had to cut out two pieces of pine 1x8 and then accurately measure them. After measuring, I just located the center of each piece. I'm using some double-sided fiber tape to hold the workpieces to the bed of the CNC. And now we go over to the CNC itself. The CNC I'm using is a Millwright Carve King. I'm using a 1/4-inch bit for bulk and an 1/8-inch bit for detail. I don't have a Z probe installed yet, so I use the piece of paper method to get my initial Z height. With these multi-tool operations, this is slightly inaccurate, as I'll show later in the video. Don't forget your hearing and eye protection when running jobs on any CNC. Thank you. Here I move on to sanding off the small burrs left by the CNC. Some hand sanding was required. If you look closely, you can see the slight ghosting marks from where my Z height on the two bits was not exactly the same. It's only a fraction of a millimeter, but it's enough to see, and it's really difficult to sand out. After sanding the surface to a 220 grit, I applied a coat of clear shellac. This is going to keep the additional layers of paint from running into the pores and grooves of the wood. And now I'm applying a couple coats of blue and yellow acrylic paint. I painted the lower areas with blue first, and that allowed me to come back with a sander and clean up any spots where my hand wasn't steady. And then I came back and painted all the high areas with the yellow. Once the paint was dried, I sprayed a couple of gloss clear coats on the whole project. After those clear coats were dried, I moved on to installing the mounting hardware. I started with finding the center of the small piece and then made two marks equidistant from the edge. I then located the center of the larger piece. Using these two center lines as a guide, I transferred the other two marks from the smaller piece onto the larger. Next, I pre-drilled some pilot holes to prevent splitting. I used 6 screw-in eye bolts as the mounting hardware. To attach the lower piece to the upper, I opened up 2 of the eye bolts with some pliers and then screwed them in. After putting 2 more eye bolts into the larger piece, I linked the other eye bolts together like chains and then closed them with pliers. With 2 more eye bolts on top, the project's ready for hanging. Thanks for watching.